Hello everyone. Welcome to this video for introducing Keysight Pathwave signal generation software. As the next generation software platform powered by Pathwave engine, it will play the role of hosting multiple signal generation applications, including general purpose, cellular network, and wireless connectivity. Now let's take 5G NR as the example to have a quick look at it. On the top level, we can see three tab pages for carrier, waveform, and hardware, respectively. Under hardware page, user can simply enter the instrument IP address or select from the saved ones, then click Connect button to make it connected. All the hardware settings shown here will be used for remote instrument control during the waveform downloading. Under waveform page, there are some general settings like waveform length, sampling rate, crest factor reduction, and one important 5G NR unique setting, phase compensation. User has the flexibility to enable or disable it, or manually set the frequency point for the phase compensation. Upon each waveform generation, IQ symbols, spectrum, and the CCDF curve will be displayed in the graphic panel at the bottom. Now 3GPP release 16.2.0 is supported, and for sure it will keep updated with 3GPP release roadmap in the future. Turning to the carrier page, this is where user can specify cell level settings, and the most important ones would be cell ID and carrier bandwidth. There are four different carrier types supported: downlink, uplink, PREG, and CW as the interference. By adding more carriers into the waveform, user would be able to create a multi-carrier signal with proper frequency offset assigned to each component carrier. Since bandwidth part is a new concept introduced in 5G NR, a dedicated layer is designed for user to config multiple BWPs within a carrier, including its location in frequency domain, assigned numerology, and core set settings. For the physical channels in the downlink and uplink, user can make channel-specific configuration individually. Take PDSH for example. It includes general settings like RNTI and power boosting, transmission settings for single layer or MIMO transmission, resource location settings in terms of the location in frequency and time domain, modulation and coding settings for user to select MCS table and index, hack settings to simulate a hack process with retransmission, DMS and PTR settings for the channel estimation. Dynamic spectrum sharing, DSS, is also supported, so user can configure multiple LTE CRS to be coexisted with 5G NR signal. The graphical display is a very convenient way for user to check the resource location in a frame, as well as the details within a single resource block. Anytime when you change a parameter value, the graphic will be refreshed instantly, so that user could have a good visualization on the signal under configuration. We can see there are extensive signal configuration wizards available, making the configuration work as easy as just one button click. For example, full field wizard, test model wizard, FRC wizard, PUCCH wizard, common uplink wizard, and PREG wizard. Okay, now let's do a demo of quick generation and analysis for 5G NR test model signal. First, we open the test model wizard, specify its bandwidth to 100 MHz, duplexing mode TDD, test model 3.1, and click OK. Then 3GPP channel profile for test model 3.1 will be automatically loaded, where we can check the related channel parameters in the table and at the same time view the resource allocation in the graphical panel. Now we click the Generate and Download button here. The signal will be generated and downloaded to the signal generator that is already connected. Then we switch to the signal analyzer and do the same operation to demodulate this test model 3.1 signal. Okay, now we can see this signal is successfully demodulated and the EVM result looks pretty good. Okay, that's all for today. If you want to explore more details about Keysight Pathwave signal generation software, please visit our website at www.keysight.com. Thanks for watching.